श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे सोहम सोहम दिस मंत्रा इज बीइंग स्पोकन ऑफ एंड टू सच एन एक्सटेंट दैट पीपल नेम देयर चाइल्ड एज सोहम मिस्टर सोहम प्लीज कम हियर व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट सोहम सी इट इज नॉट ओनली अ वर्ड सहा द सुप्रीम रियलिटी अहम I am. So, what do we take ourselves to be? When I identify myself with the body, then I am man, woman, young, old, husband, wife, and this battalion is always miserable. Never try to help or improve these fictitious personalities which come out of us like the waves come out of the ocean in the same manner. All these fictitious personalities, they come out of us only after body identification. And therefore, here the teacher told us, Yadi deham prithakritya chiti vishramya tishtasi. If you understand this basic principle of spiritual life, देहं पृथक् कृत्य कीप दिस बॉडी अवे इनफ ऑफ दिस बॉडी 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 सी यू ऑल मस्ट हैव सीन वेरियस मुद्रास यू नो डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मुद्रास अमंग सो मेनी मुद्रास देर इज वन मुद्रा दिस टाइप दिस मुद्रा इज कॉल्ड एज ज्ञान मुद्रा एंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस ज्ञान मुद्रा We have five layers under which we are buried. The five layers are the Annamaya Kosha, the gross body, Pranamaya Kosha, the powerhouse, Manomaya Kosha, the means of communication, Vijnanamaya Kosha, Mr. I, Anandamaya Kosha is the origin of the four. When this I, Vijnanamaya Kosha, is identified with the mind and its modification, this I becomes happy, miserable. When this Vijnanamaya Kosha I gets identified with the Pranamaya Kosha, he becomes hungry and thirsty. When this Vijnanamaya Kosha I becomes identified with the body, he becomes young, old, healthy, unhealthy, tall, short, etc. And till such time, this I is identified with the three, samsara will never end. Then, this is the instruction given to us. Disidentify from the three. And where will this go? Merge it in the bliss. This is the meaning of this mudra. It is not a snuff mudra. Do you have snuffs? I can do it. It is not a snuff mudra. See? So, deha prathakritya. Get rid of this body identification. Now the question comes, how do we get rid of body identification? So again we play. See? Don't make spiritual life as if, you know, we are in the, concentration chamber of the Hitler. Spiritual life is joy, freedom, happiness, relaxation, celebration. See, it is not in a concentration camp. So, let us play meditation, let us play spiritual life. And what is that? First, if I am other than the body, means what? Means none of the worldly things and beings can influence me, because the worldly things and beings influence me only after I am identified with the body in the waking state. So what is to be done now? No person and no object in this world should have freedom to bother us. This is our choice. When I become miserable because of anybody, I am the fool of the highest order. If I become miserable because of anything, I am the fool of the highest order. How dare anything or being can disturb me? Keep the freedom intact. This lifestyle is called as spiritual lifestyle. Otherwise, somebody tells you, oh, you are extremely intelligent. The frog is becoming a bull. The next person tells, you are dumb. Again, it is collapsing and going into the hibernation. No friends. We are what we are, not because people say. See? Therefore, yadi deham prithakritya. So when we are away and other than the body, means none of the things and beings in the world will disturb us. Then how do we live? Chiti vishramya tishtasi. Now we no more live as the body, but we start living as consciousness. See, friends. And when we start living as consciousness, three things happen in life. Number one, we live and let others live. We don't deceive anybody and nobody can deceive us. We are happy and don't make anybody miserable. This becomes a natural lifestyle, because now there is nobody who is expressing through the body. It is the pure conscious reality. Then adhuna eva sukhihi sukhi shantaha. Now and here you will be at peace and blissful. It is not posthumous. After you die, you will go to heaven. After you die, you will go to hell. It is for KG1, KG2 children. Hell and heaven, last life, this life, next life. This is not the truth. See, friends. You know, it is extremely necessary for us to recognize why these things are told in the scriptures. It is not for us to be sent to the hell or heaven. See? So when we talk and walk the spiritual path, we should be strong enough. Upanishad says, Nayam Atma Balahine Nalabhyaha. The truth is not for those who are cowards, who are dropouts in life, who are frustrated, who are depressed and dejected. So when we are unfit for everything, we are fit for spirituality. No. When we are fit for everything and yet we reject the whole world, then we are fit for spirituality. See, friends. Therefore, adhuna eva sukhi shantaha bandha mukto bhavishyasi. You shall be liberated from all the funny notions that you have. That you are good, you are bad. Some people say you are good, some people say you are bad. No, none of these things will ever bother you. Up to here we have seen. Now the question is, how do we practice this knowledge? See, practicing karma is different. See, every day you get up and wash your clothes, put them for drying, karma. Practice every day. We can easily understand. Practicing yoga is still easier. Get up in the morning, do n number of asanas, do the pranayam from here and get confused. Or do the trataka. Very easy, it's not difficult at all. The real challenge comes practicing knowledge. In practicing knowledge, the practice of knowledge is 24/7. See, you cannot do pranayam 24/7. You cannot do asana 24/7. But the practice of knowledge is 24/7. Because we live 24/7. Otherwise, half an hour meditation and 23.5 hour frustration. It is not spiritual life. We have to live all the time. Therefore, how do we practice? Natvam vipro diko varno nashrami nakshagocharaha asangosi nirakaro vishvasakshi sukhi bhava. Be happy, sukhi bhava. First principle of spiritual life. Nothing in this world can justify that we are miserable. The first principle of spiritual life, be happy. And when we, even if you are not happy, pretend. Suppose somebody asks you, how are you? Don't tell the truth. Here, this is one peculiar thing I noticed in UK. Yesterday or day before yesterday, I met somebody when we were going for a walk with one of my friends. And there was one elderly person, he was walking. So I had to ask some direction. Is there any garden near about? So his wife told, there is no nearby garden. That certain garden is far away, you have to go by car. I said, it's okay, never mind. And to that old man who was pushing the trolley with the grandchild, I said, Papa, how is life? Really not very good. Suppose he has said, I am happy, will he lose anything? We don't want to discover the truth. See, friend, Sukhi Bhava, insist that you are happy. You are not miserable. See, therefore, Natvam Vipradiko Varnaha. Now you are none of these various kinds of classes. You know, according to the Sanatana Dharma, there are four types of people who are classified according to their quality. They are Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. Brahmana is the one who is basically knowledge oriented. Kshatriya is the one who is basically activity oriented. Vaishya is the one whose activities are selfishly done. And Shudra is the one who takes a government job and does nothing. These are the four types of people in this world. So the teacher says, don't get lost in these classifications. Whatever work you are supposed to do, do it cheerfully, happily, and forget. See, friends. Otherwise, we get lost so much in all these non-essentials. So, natvam vipradiko varano na ashrami. The second place where we get lost is the four ashramas. The brahmachari, grahastha, vanaprastha, sannyasi. So, I am a brahmachari, I am a grahastha, I am a vanaprasthi, I am a sannyasi. And thus we tie us down with too many knots here and there. Get out of all of them. Live as a human being. See? Recently I have produced some t-shirts for sale in Bombay. Because the place where I stay, that person told me, Swamiji, give me some beautiful t-shirts for all my labor class. So when they are working, at least when they look at each other, they will be happy. So my logo is Be Happy logo. So in that Be Happy logo, I have put the message. Being human is being happy. simple it is. Spiritual life is not that you make your face and like that as if you have taken handful of caterpillars and some putting in your mouth. That is not spiritual life. See, friends, therefore, natvam varnadiko vipradiko varnaha na ashrami. Don't get lost in small little cocoons. And na akshagocharaha. And nor you are any of the sense objects or the sense organs. Meaning, don't be a slave to any sense organ. See, friends, how many small little things disturb us? Small little things. Unless this particular thing is there, I cannot. See, na akshagocharaha. And then who am I? Asangosi, you are unattached. Attachment is an illusion. We are not attached to anything or anybody in this world. We only say we are not. See, friends, you must have seen when in an old family, husband and wife, one of them has to die first. So the one who is living, you observe the dialogues. Oh, without him, how can I live? I cannot live without him, or I cannot live without her. 5-10 minutes crying happens, body is disposed of, and then the other people are waiting. Oh, she said that without him she cannot live. So they are waiting for her departure. But this lady doesn't go. Continues. So that kind of attachment is only illusion. We are not attached to anything. Take for example, when we are wanting to enter sleep, exactly what we do? We detach ourselves from everything and everybody, and then only we go to sleep. And it is natural for us. Therefore, asangosi, only come to recognize we are not attached to anything. And that is the truth. Like I gave example in the morning, eyes are not attached to any color and form. Sounds are not attached to any particular type of sound. Mind is not attached to any theme. And therefore, the mind is jumping from one theme to another theme like a monkey. One moment the mind thinks about the food, next moment about the clothes, third moment about the weather, fourth moment about the memories, where the mind is attached. And so also, the conscious reality that we are not attached to either the waking, dream, deep sleep and samadhi. They come and go like the clouds come in the space from nowhere and they disappear nowhere. All that is required is only remain in utter awareness. You are not attached to anything. That is all. Therefore, the real spiritual life is living in utter awareness. Don't give undue importance to the prakriti. Prakriti, matter is the one which is subject to vikruti modification. You cannot stop it. But if we keep all the time attention only on this thing, I should be healthy. On the contrary, those who have got some problems are unhealthy, they are lucky. They will get detachment towards the body. See, all the terrorists in the world, they are all healthy. No terrorist is having any disease. Therefore, asangosi, only come to discover that we are unattached, then nirakaraha, we do not have any form. One of the techniques given in Vijnana Bhairava for meditation is this. Sit in a dark room, not a speck of light. Keep your eyes open. Because there is darkness, you cannot see anything. But seeing is happening. When seeing is happening, without anything to see, seer is not born. Seeing without the seer is the truth. We are not doing anything. All the spiritual practice is undoing. It is not becoming spiritual. If we become spiritual, we will revert back to the samsara again. Therefore, asangosi nirakaraha. What is our shape when we are in deep sleep? Round, straight, crooked, triangular, square. Be attentive. What is the shape of the mind? What is the shape of the vision? Truth is that which is always formless. What is the shape of the gold? When we study in metallurgy, any metal, we study all the qualities except one. Metal does not have any shape. That which doesn't have any shape, any form, alone can take every shape and every form, and yet remains shapeless, formless. Asangosi nirakaraha. Vishwasakshi sukhi bhava. Vishwasakshi. You are the witness of Mr. Waker. See, friends, there are two lights which are illuminating every experience. One light is when the joy comes, we become joyful and we say, I am happy. When the misery comes, we get identified with the misery and we say, I am miserable. So one experience is illumined by becoming one with the experience, and an experiencer is born. The second one is the one which illuminates the experience, the object of experience, and also the experiencer. And thus is beyond this triputi, the three. The experiencer, experience, and experienced. Vishwasakshi. I know I am miserable. So this one who knows this miserable I is definitely someone other than this miserable entity. And this miserable I is also not permanent. 5 minutes miserable, 5 minutes happy. 5 minutes confused, 5 minutes convinced. They keep on changing the definitions. But there is one principle which is illuminating all these individualities and beyond all of them. Vishwasakshi Sukhi Bhava. Thus come to discover your essential nature, and all the differences and multiplicity is born only out of the conditioning through which we are expressing. The truth is one. Because of the conditioning, it is referred as many. It is something like this. Man is one. With reference to his father, he is called as a son. With reference to his wife, he is called as a husband. With reference to his son, he is called as a father. So this one man, has he become three? He is only one. Take the subjective experience. One mind, expressing through the eyes, called as vision. The same mind coming out of the ears is called as the hearing ability. Has the mind become five because of the five senses? No. It is because of the gadgets which are applied. Therefore, one appears to be many. Exactly the same way. One truth. With the conditioning of the names and forms, it is called as the world. The same reality. With the conditioning of the panchakoshas, the three bodies, is called as the jiva. The same reality with the conditioning of the maya, the divine potentiality is called as Ishvara. So that one reality is referred as jiva jagat Ishvara. The soul, the world and the God. All of them are supported by the one reality. Like the man supports the son, the husband and the father. This one reality is our essential nature. Sukhi bhava. Be happy. See, there are no tensions. We are not going to gain anything. At the same time, we are not going to lose anything. Why we are not going to gain anything? Because we are that. Why we are not going to lose anything? Because nothing is ours. Right from our body onwards. Our body doesn't belong to us. It is created by the parents. It belongs to them, not to us. We are merely the tenants. When we come to this equation that in this world there is nothing to gain and nothing to lose, we have transcended the relativity. It is only in the finite alone that gain and loss has a meaning. In the infinite one, there is neither gain nor loss. Thus asangosi nirakaro vishvasakshi sukhi bhava. Who can practice this knowledge? The one who has withdrawn from the world through wisdom, not through frustration. Because somebody ditched and went away, so somewhere there was, you know, loss, tremendous loss, all money that I invested, the market has collapsed and I also collapsed. It is not for those. It is for the one who has rejected the world with freedom. See, friends. Visvasakshi sukhi bhava. धर्मा धर्मौ सुखं दुःखं मानसानि नते विभो न कर्तासि न भोक्तासि मुक्त एवासि सर्वदा. Another place where we get caught up in our life is dharma, adharma, righteousness and sinful lifestyle. You know, masses are controlled by this opium of dharma. What is called as religion. See, once I delivered three talks in a university in India and they gave me, Swamiji, talk something on religion, spirituality, philosophy, something, whatever you like, you talk. I said, you have given me already the topic, so we'll have three talks on these three words, religion, philosophy and the spirituality. And on the last day we concluded, in religion there is no God, in philosophy there is no wisdom. Where God and wisdom coexist is spirituality. See, friends, like religion, every religion talks about God and every one of them say God is one. But their fighting is like what? I happened to meet one couple after 15 years of their marriage. And both of them were complaining, "Swamiji, we are constantly fighting. I don't know what we should do," husband said, wife said. I said, "Look here, I remember I had come for your marriage. What I told you? Do you remember? I told you, now you are married, you are one. If there are two, then there is a fight possible. If you are one, how can you fight?" "Swamiji, the fight is on that issue only." "What is the issue? Which one?" Exactly the same way. All religions say God is one, but which one? My God or your God? See, friends. So here the teacher is telling, dharma, adharma. This is the religious field. Don't get involved in that. Because in religion, they have to control the masses. And how the masses can be controlled? By a remote control. And there are two switches. One switch is the switch of guilt. And second switch is the switch of fear. So they will induct guilt in their followers. "If you do this thing, you are a sinner." Then what is to be done? "Go and confess. I have done this thing." "Never mind. Don't do it next time. I also did, but it's okay." See? And with that guilt in your mind, you will be always leading a fearful life. And second thing is fear. "If you do this thing, he will go to hell." Under the fear, we can get anything done. See? Once, you know, somewhere somebody I met and he told me, "Do you believe in our God?" I said, "Yes." "Then you are following our religion?" I said, "Yes." "But then you are a Hindu?" I said, "Yes." "How this is possible?" I said, "The latest technology, 2-in-1. So when I said like this thing, then I was cursed. "If you say like this thing, you will go to hell." Then I asked, "Where will you go?" "Of course I will go to heaven." I said, "If you are going to heaven, I will prefer to go to hell." See, friends, this hell and heaven is a fear for the babies. It has nothing to do with the reality. Therefore, dharma, adharma, sukham, dukham. In Kathopanishad, I think we studied Kathopanishad here some time back. If you have forgotten, it's a great thing. You know, in Kathopanishad, the student is Nachiket. He asks a question to his guru, the Lord Death. Anyatra dharmat, anyatra adharmat, anyatra asmat kruta krutat, anyatra bhutaccha bhavyaccha, yattat pashyasi tadvada. Oh teacher, tell me that it is other than the dharma adharma, the religion and non-religious. I am not interested in any religion. Anyatra asmat kruta krutat. Don't tell me the cause and effect. I don't believe in cause and effect. Cause and effect is an illusion. It is the highest bluff. There is nothing like cause, there is nothing like effect. See? And then, anyatra bhutaccha bhavyaccha. Tell me that which has nothing to do with the past, present and the future. Because time is another bluff. See, many times it must be, here it doesn't happen probably, but in US it happens. You travel 3 hours. 7 o'clock your flight takes off and you land at 7 o'clock. That means you are not traveled. But you traveled 3 hours. What happened to those 3 hours? See, time is not the real, it's just another illusion. So don't tell me all that. Tell me that. What is your direct experience? Yattat pashyasi tadvada. Therefore here, Ashtavakra very clearly tells us that dharma, dharma, don't get lost into the sin and the merit, hell and the heaven, last life, this life and the next life. This has nothing to do with the reality. See, one person from Australia, he asked me this question. See, you people are Hindus, you believe in the reincarnation, rebirth. But we don't believe. How can we understand your Gita? I said, look here, who told you that we believe in rebirth? We don't believe in birth. Nobody is born. Bhagavan says very clearly in Gita, Ajopi san navyayatma bhutanamishwaropi san. I am never born. And nobody is ever born. What is born is this body. And if we are not the body, where is the place for that I am born? See, this bulb is born. The light in the bulb is never born. If the bulb is without the light, the bulb is no useful. And what is really useful is not the bulb, the light. In the same manner, the body is born, the body will die. But the embodied, who is functioning through the body, is never born, never does he die. So there is a place for going to hell and heaven, sin and merit. Therefore, dharma, dharma, sukham, dukkham. Similarly, the joy and sorrows. These are another illusions. In the winter, the heat is very comfortable. The same heat is miserable in the summer. In the summer, the cool, cold climate is very good. But the same cold in the winter is terrible. See? Therefore, joy, sorrows, etc., they are all relative. They are not real. Sukham, dukham. Then, manasani nate vibho. And they are functional only as long as the mind is functional. Be very attentive. That which is not included in the mind does not exist for us. Simple rule. The other day somewhere in India, they have put a garland on me. And with the garland on, I was giving the lecture. In that garland, there was a caterpillar or some kind of caterpillar. And the caterpillar started from the garland, came on my beard. And I don't know, because beard doesn't have any, you know, nervous tissue. So it came and then it went cross all the way. And then it came on my hand. When it came on my hand, then I could see that the caterpillar has come. Then slowly I just removed it and continued my lecture. So after the lecture was over, one girl came and asked, Swamiji, when that caterpillar was going on your this thing, didn't you get disturbed? I said, why? I didn't know that. But we saw. I said, it may be existing for you. It didn't exist for me. That which is not included in our mind does not exist for us. See, once I had something in my toe. So my friend, doctor friend told Swamiji, we have to operate it before it becomes very bad. I said, let's go. Straight away from my lecture, I went to his surgery. And he said, it is a local thing, I will do it, give local anesthesia. So in the big toe, he put the needles and gave some injections. And after 10 minutes, he said, are you feeling? I said, what? That means you are not feeling. And he said, you can see that operation, what I am doing. Like we take out the ice cream by scoop, in the same manner, I was seeing very clearly, not in the mirror, but straight away. He took the scalpel and put straight away into the toe, and like this he removed, uprooted, as if some plant is uprooted, and the whole thing came out intact. He said, see, these roots would have migrated and then it becomes difficult. It's good we did it right now. So although I saw that, there was no pain, because in that area, mind was blocked. So where is every existing? Everything is existing only in the mind. Be attentive. How the things enter our mind? The things enter our mind when we have given importance to anything or anybody. If we get a news that in Cambodia there was such a big accident, so many people died. What is our interaction? These days everywhere accidents are happening. We become philosophers. And if we get further, and in that accident, one person of Indian origin was badly injured and he is in the hospital. Oh, Indians go everywhere. Another philosophy. And the name of that Indian is so and so. And then we suddenly get a shock. Oh God, he is my brother. And everything changes. See, friends. Therefore, what is the rule? The rule is dharma, adharma, righteousness, wrong thing, joy, sorrows. They are valid as long as the mind is functional. They are only in the mind. See, friends. Manasani nate vivo. They are not ours. They are only in the mind. See? The other day, somebody was in coma. And their people called me for dinner. After the food was over, they said, Swamiji, please bless our grandmother. So what will I bless? Somebody is in coma. Because to receive the blessing, she should be alive. So, all the tubes all around. I went there, the nurse was there, I was talking to her. And then these owners, the people came to see how I bless that old lady who is in coma. So, I had to do the drama and I am a good actor. So I took her hand in my palm and my hand I put on her dead palm and kissed my hand. Who will kiss that dirty dead hand, you know? And then I just moved the lips. Because I don't know what to pray. Should I pray, oh God, take her away? Or should I pray, oh God, revive her? If she gets revived, they will kill me. And if she goes away because of her prayer, then I am a dangerous person. Don't pray for anybody. So I just did a drama and over. After some time, they came, Swamiji, thank you very much that day you came. Then I was worried, no, what happened? Because I didn't do anything. No, we could not see her pain. She was in coma for last 6 months and therefore it's good God has taken her away. Now be attentive. A person who is in coma, he is never miserable. The person who has to pay the bills, he is miserable. Because a person in coma doesn't own the body. It is only a vegetable. That's all. Therefore, all these dharma, adharma, sukham, dukkham, they belong to the mind. And therefore, na kartasi, you are not the doer. See, friends, this is what we have to practice knowledge. Therefore, I told you in the morning class, don't do meditation. If you will do meditation, then you are the doer. And anything which begins in time will end in time. We don't have to do meditation for half an hour. Remain in meditation all through your life. We have to live in meditation. If you do meditation, it will begin and it will end. And thereafter, what? Frustration. And during meditation also, frustration only. Only thing we don't tell others. Because everybody is frustrated. See, control the mind, keep the mind quiet. Saying is different. Inside, volcanoes are erupting non-stop. See, friends. Na kartasi. Give up this notion that we have done something in this world. Things are just happening. And one of the highest spiritual practice, according to me, is to get out of this law of karma. This law of karma is a catch. It is not real. Things are not happening because we have done something good or bad. Things are happening because of the divine will. See, friends. And when we accept this way, then the doer will disappear from our system. And when the doer is disappeared, then there is no sin, there is no merit. See, friends. That is why, you know, those who are caught up in this yoga and karma, they get lost only in this purification, purification, purification. For the devotee, no purification. All that is happening is divine will. Something good happens, God's grace. Something bad happens, God's grace. One story I'll tell you. There was one king and he had an old minister. And old people have got some kind of habits. He also had. His habit was, when anything happens, he used to say, "Thank God, God is great. It is so nice of him." The old king died. That time also, he said the same thing. "Thank God, God is great." And then the prince became the king. And when the prince was walking, that old minister also walking with the king. And the king toppled down from the palace. And when he fell down, again the old man, "Thank God, God is great." And when the king reached the last step in that toppling, he lost his small finger, it got cut. Again the old man, "Thank God, God is great." Now this king got very angry. Put him behind the bars. "Useless fellow, thank God. I got hurt and he says, thank God. God is great." So when he was put behind the bar, he again said the same thing. "Thank God, God is great. I am going behind the bars." And the king as usual went for hunting in the forest. And the Kapalikas who offered the human sacrifice to the goddess, they caught hold of the king. And they wanted to sacrifice. And he was given a nice bath, everything, clothes removed, and to be offered. So the pujari, the pandit, he says, "Let me take the offering to the mother." And when he was checking all the parts of the body, he found left hand has got only four fingers. The fifth finger is not there. He said, "We cannot offer it to the mother. It is not complete. We cannot offer." So he was relieved. Then he remembered that old man said, "Thank God, God is great, really. Had his finger been there, I would have been sacrificed." He straight away rushes to the jail and tells, "What you said, I understood now. All that happens is God's grace. But tell me, when I put you behind the bar, that time also you said the same thing. What was great about it?" He said, "Had I not been behind the bar, I would have come with you. And in lieu of you, I would have been sacrificed. Therefore, it was good that I was behind the bars." A devotee of the Lord bypasses the law of karma. Don't get lost in this law of karma. Prarabdha karma, sanchit karma, agami karma, how the karmas are burned, and this karma. Don't get lost. It is only a method of communication. There is nothing like karma. Karma is in the field of foolishness. See, in Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan says, "Adhishthanam tatha karta karanam cha prutak vidam vividha cha prutak cheshta daivam chaivatra panchamam." These are the five factors involved for the execution of any karma. And how do we take the total credit? And the last one is daivam chaivatra panchamam. Unless there is a divine sanction, nothing can ever happen in this world. See, friends, so why not get out of this catch of karma? Therefore, na kartasi. Now, how do we get rid of this kartrutva abhiman, the sense of doership? Number one, whatever we are doing in this world doesn't need us. First principle. When we were not in this world, there was nothing lacking. When we will live in this world, there will be no lacuna. Therefore, our presence in this world is most uncalled for. But we have this funny notion, without me, how the world can move? See, friends. Then why should we work? Because it is our need. And whenever we do something with our need, we have humility, we have submission, we don't have arrogance. See, you must experience it. When we go through the immigration, in any country you go, that time we talk to the immigration officer, our best. Good afternoon. Why? Because it is our need to enter that country. We don't go there arrogantly. Hey, come on, hurry up. No, because it is our need. So, nakartasi. Get rid of this wrong notion that because of us the things are moving. One person asked me once this question. When your Krishna is going to descend in this world? I said, he told me there's a lot of time, there is no hurry. He said, this is the worst period in the history of humanity. See, everywhere terrorism and things are happening. Why he is not coming down? So I asked him, why earlier the periods were not bad? I don't think they were so bad. Very good. Afterwards, the time will not be bad. I don't think it can be worse than today. Very good. You were there earlier? No. You will be there later? No. Now the world is terribly horrible and you are there. So who is the cause? You are the cause. You change. Changing oneself is spiritual life. Changing the world is the political or the social life. Therefore, here, na kartasi. In the fifth chapter of Gita, Bhagavan says, Yoginaha karma kurvanti sangam tyaktva atma shuddhaye. Everything is done not for improving the world. It is done for our inner purification. And what is the purification? If we do not keep ourselves physically occupied, our mind will start spinning and we will get in the wrong channel of thinking. On the contrary, if you are occupied, the best way to control the mind is to keep the mind occupied. Occupied mind is a controlled mind. You know, our meditation is like what? We sit for meditation and it is something like a truck which is going upwards, heavily loaded, and suddenly the cows or the sheep are crossing. So the truck has to stop. No, he will not switch off. Who knows if it doesn't start again? So he keeps on pumping. But it is not moving. Exactly the same way. We sit for meditation. Inside, we are not moving outside. But inside, like the million revolutions per second. Meditation. See, friends. It's only because I am doing the meditation. Nakartasi. That is the reason why the japa sadhana is done. Japa sadhana is done to keep the mind occupied. Om Sri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. Om Sri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. Mind is occupied. If the mind is not busy, then I should do this, I should do that, and all problems. Therefore, come to recognize, to get rid of the doership is to know. Nobody needs our karma. It is our need, therefore we are doing. The third thing, to get rid of the doership. Where do we see the result of our karma? It is something like, you know, I am talking to you, this is a karma. Speech is a karmendriya. It's a karma. So where do I focus my attention? Am I trying to see that because of my lectures you will improve? If this I am trying to do, I will be utter failure in my life. Then, am I trying to see that I am a great lecturer, then I have buried myself. Then where to keep the attention? Only on the quality of the mind. Before we take up any job, during the execution of the job, after the job is complete, is the quality of our mind untouched as it was? Like before anybody comes in front of the mirror, mirror is at peace. When somebody looks into the mirror, mirror is at peace. When the person goes away, mirror continues to be at peace. Is our mind like the mirror, which reflects everything, rejects nothing, at the same time retains nothing? If this quality is maintained, then we have given up the sense of doership. And when the sense of doership is given, there is neither sin nor merit, neither dharma nor adharma. Na kartasi, na bhoktasi. See, the earlier verse, the words are dharmo dharmau na kartasi, sukham dukham na bhoktasi. So there may be sukha, the joy and sorrows in life. Be very attentive. We can attribute joy and sorrows to some cause. The miseries in my life are because of my wife. Agreed. But I am miserable by my choice. See, God never makes us miserable. God never makes us happy. It is we who have chosen. Like you must have seen, you know, when you enter the immigration, you are given a form. You have to fill in the form. And some countries, the form are very long. Our UK form is very short, quickly. There is not too much of things. In some countries, they will be writing a big list. Had you been to any farm? Are you a member of active terrorist organization? How many people you have killed in your life? Like that, blah, 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 blah. So who will say, are you a member of active terrorist organization? Yes. Everyone will say, no, 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 no. In the same manner, when we were entering this world, God gave us a form, immigration form. And on that form it was written, you are entering anityam asukham lokam prapya imam majasvamam. You are entering the abode called as a kingdom of miseries, the world. Question, do you want to be miserable? Options, yes, no. Those who are tick mark, yes, they are miserable. Those who are tick mark, no, they are happy. See, friends, nobody can make us miserable. We don't have to cooperate with the misery. Be apart. Therefore, namhoktasi, it is our choice. So neither you are the doer, nor you are the enjoyer. In this manner, mukta evasi sarvada. Thus you are ever liberated man. You are not bound. See, we only imagine, I am so unlucky, I am so miserable, I don't know why. No, you are not. Reject. See, there is, you know, a very simple spiritual practice. Anybody ask you any time, fire, roar, how are you? I am on the top of the world. The other person should get shaken up. Oh God, where is he? But our words should carry the meaning. Otherwise somebody says, how are you? I am on the top of the world. This is being at the bottom of the world, not on the top of the world. Discover this freedom. Mukta eva asi sarvada. You are ever, ever liberated. You are not bound. Eko drashtasi sarvasya mukta prayohisi sarvada ayame vahite bandho drashtaram pashyasi taram. Ekaha drashtasi sarvasya. You are the one observer of everything, and therefore you are ever liberated. Your bondage is this. You are trying to see yourself. And your bondage is this. You are trying to see yourself as other than you. This is your bondage. Some more aspects of this particular thought we'll see in our next class. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnamat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om.
शांति शांति हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम।